synchronous diving is perfection of two divers to become one, and to show this to the people that it's fascinating. And yeah, it's just fun to try to do everything exactly the same.
So there's two heights you can do synchro diving. One is 3 meter springboard and one is 10 meter platform.
Every synchro team has 6 dives to do. 2 are required and 4 are optional. So we can choose 4 dives with our own difficulty. And the first 2 dives have a required difficulty of 2.0.
After 6 dives, the synchro pair who has the most points is the winner. In synchronized diving, there are 9 judges. There are 5 judges for the synchronized and 4 for the individual.
Judges are supposed to just watch the thing they have to do. So the executional judges, they don't need to look for synchronization, just for individual diving, and they score that individual diving. And synchro has just to look at synchro.
They look in of all the synchronized on the whole dive, on the takeoff, the twist or spinning in the air, if you're together, and on the entry for sure.
If both enter straight into the water, it's good points. But if they're not straight and one is a little bit splashy and the other one is not, that's less points. Best and the lowest mark are going to be out. They're out of the score. And then you multiply with the difficulty and then you got the score. And you get penalized more on synchro because you have 3 synchro scores and just 2 executional scores that build your overall score. So 3-2, you have more influence on synchro. The more somersaults and twists you have in a dive, the more difficulty you have. So every team is trying to do the most difficulty dives they can, but they have to control it. If you're doing difficulty dives but you can't control it, it's not worth it. So everyone has to find a little way to have a good difficulty and still a good quality of the dives.
Our coaches tell us what dives we have to do, and we try to have hard optional dives. So we have to choose the optionals first. So maybe you're gonna do front, twist, and back. So you have to do front and inward in requires. That's what we do.
The front 4.5 somersault and the inward 4.5 somersaults. Yeah, inward 4.5 somersaults is quite a new dive in from 10 meter. And I think there was just 1 or 2 teams who did that, but it's not regular. Most divers are doing front 4.5 still. They have to twist very, very fast, and inward is kind of a dangerous type of dive because you have to twist to the platform, and yeah, it can be scary because you can't dive far away from the board, so you're not twisting that fast, and that's why it's a really hard dive.
When we stay up there and the judges call in the dive, he says go, and then we go to the top of the 10 meter platform, and then he says maybe arms up, then we do the arms up, and when I'm ready I say okay, and after that he says ready, go.
This is something you practice very much. You practice it at dry land, of course, and you're doing somersaults, and all the time you're doing like 1, 2, 3 go, ready, and all that stuff, so that it's getting automatically in your head.
We started back in 2007 to practice together, and we saw that we are really good together, and I just always try to do bigger dives, and it works really good.
A partnership is really important because if you're not friends with each other, you're not working that good together. Diving is not fun, practicing is not fun, competition is not fun, and so I'm sure your dives will be worse